Hey everyone, and welcome back to the DevOps Lab. I'm Damian Braden, and I'm joined by Edward Thomson from the not VSTS team anymore.
It is not the VSTS team.
It's the Azure DevOps team.
Azure DevOps.
Yeah, as of, what, last week at time of recording?
Last week.
Yeah, yeah. Nice. So there were a lot of announcements. I don't want to go through everything, but the big thing, the kind of draw card for me was the Azure Pipelines.
Yes.
Right? And in particular, the open source offering for Azure Pipelines.
Right, right. We're incredibly excited about it. It's our way of giving back to the open source community. We are providing free access to Azure Pipelines, which is our continuous integration and continuous delivery service for open source projects. We're giving them unlimited build minutes across 10 parallel pipelines.
So this is like hosted builds and your own personal builds and things like that. So you don't need any of your own infrastructure, right?
That's exactly right. Yeah, so we'll host all of the build infrastructure for you in the cloud. So we have Windows, of course, build agents in the cloud.
Yeah. Yep.
Surprise. But we also have Linux and Mac OS. And I think we're the only provider that has all three available hosted for you. But, you know, if you have something custom, you can also bring your own infrastructure if you want. But, you know, most open source projects, I maintain an open source project. I don't want to bring anything. I just want it handled for me,
yes.
Right?
So. Yeah, yeah, exactly. And there's a few flavors of like the Linux build pipeline and things. Oh, the Linux build agent, is that right?
Yeah, so what I recommend you do is just use the out-of-the-box build agent. We've got one for you that's Ubuntu 16.04.
Uh-huh.
And then if you want to, say, build on a different environment, let's say you want to run on CentOS, no problem,
sure.
Do that in a Docker image. So that's how I've got my stuff set up. So I can really just customize exactly the dependencies that I want.
Yep.
And just spin up my builds in a Docker image.
Nice.
Yeah.
So we're at NDC Sydney at the moment.
Yes.
Which is cool. I just arrived like an hour ago. So I'm jet lagged. I came all the way from the Gold Coast. It's like an hour or something. You can clearly tell that I'm jet lagged.
Yeah, it's terrible.
anyway, so here at NDC Sydney, I haven't seen anything, but I've seen a few people tweeting about Azure DevOps at a few sessions. You did a talk on Git at scale, right?
I did.
And so Git is one of these things that you've been involved with like for a long time, right?
It's been a while, yeah.
You've got the shirt. That's probably not a new shirt, I'm guessing.
It's not. This was from when I worked at GitHub.
Right.
Yeah.
So one of the things that came out with this announcement as well was integration with GitHub.
Yes.
Right?
That's
especially
right.
For open source tooling.
Yes.
Yeah,
yeah, that's exactly right. So as part of our giveaway for two open source projects, we built a marketplace app for GitHub. So it's super easy to acquire. So if you've got, you know, so here I've got a simple open source project. This is just a .NET framework application, and it's a command line app. I actually built this to help me work on Git repositories. So this is a hex dump app, like the BSD command line application.
Uh-huh.
And if I want to get started with Azure Pipelines, all I have to do is go into the marketplace that's up here. Let's see. There we go. So I just click on the marketplace there in GitHub. And that brings me to the marketplace. If I scroll down and find continuous integration here over in the side, then I can add Azure Pipelines right there. So it's super simple to get started. I've already got Azure Pipelines configured for a couple of my accounts, of course, but I can add it to another one. So all I have to do is click on Edit Your Plan. Actually, no, let me set up a new plan instead. And then click for free, and boom. And it just explains again that 10 free parallel jobs and unlimited build minutes, and I just click Install for free.
So one thing I noticed as well was the, you can see it on the left there, the 1,800 minutes per month for private pipelines.
That's right.
That used to be, what, 240 minutes a month or something like that?
I forget what it used to be, but yeah, now it's 1,800. So, if you're not using open source, or if you're not developing open source, rather, you can still take advantage of Azure Pipelines, but the offer isn't quite as generous.
No.
Right.
All right.
Because again, you know, the open source community does so much for us, for all of us. So all I have to do is select which account I want to install it into. Obviously, I've already got it on mine. I've already got it on libgit2, which is a project I help maintain.
Nice.
Got it on a couple others. So I'll select this demo one, and then just click complete order, and it'll have me log in.
Yep. You can restrict to specific repos, so it's not
That's right, yeah. That's right. I find it easiest just to do one at a time as I'm going. Mm-hmm. And it'll just make me confirm.
That is a long password.
Yeah.
That's what you want.
I'm only a little paranoid about my source and that's up in GitHub.
There you go.
Yeah. And so, and now I just log in with a Microsoft account.
Mm-hmm. And you've got a few of them as well.
Got a few of them as well. Oh no. Well, that's fine. I'll just go ahead and use this one. Yeah, that's the funny thing about testing software. You end up with a lot of accounts on your projects. And so I can either use an existing Azure DevOps organization if I'm already using Azure DevOps, or if I'm not, I can just create a new organization. And if I wasn't, if I didn't have anything at all, it would just go ahead and create me a new one. Just very simple, very straightforward. But since I'm already an Azure DevOps user, it's guiding me through this process in case I want to create a new account or use my own.
Right.
I can choose where my projects get hosted. That's important for a lot of people knowing where their code is, like geographically.
Yes.
We're here at NDC Sydney, so it's thinking I want to be in Australia. You know what? That's fine. And I'll name my project. Because of course we have Azure DevOps takes advantage of Azure's data center, so we've got data centers all over the world.
And there's a lot that get used. Do you know how many there are? They're kind of scattered all over, right?
They are. Yeah. There's a couple in the US, a couple in Europe. That's all I remember offhand. I think I knew that there was one in Australia, but I always forget because it's not that old.
No. Well, yeah, there's Sydney, there's Australia Southeast and Australia East. And then there's also a couple more now. There's a government one and something or other else one.
Crazy.
Yeah.
So now we're in Azure Pipelines. And so all I have to do is select my repository, and it will pull that down from GitHub and examine it. Mm-hmm. And it's going to look and see what I'm building. And it's going to suggest something for me. Like I said, I've just got a command line .NET framework app, so that's the template it chooses for me. But if it had found like a package.json, it would suggest a Node.js template. And so I'll just select that, and then I get to see it. So I can review this here, but it's super straightforward. It's going to run NuGet, it's going to run MS Build, and then it's going to run the tests.
Nice.
So that's a great way to get started.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I could customize this, but like I said, this is basically what I want. Mm-hmm. And so I'll just click Save and Run, and then it will actually just check a YAML file into my repository. So that's, you know, configuration as code. It's exactly what you want. You want your build description version right alongside your code, so that if you go change branches, you know, go to an old release, that you've still got the build description for how that release was built.
Right, because that always used to be the problem, right? You have your build definition and you have various branches. You're going to change your code, and so you need to build it differently. Which one do you break first?
Right, right. Terrible. Oh, yeah. That was terrible. So this is, configuration as code is amazing.
Yep.
I could use a pull request, or I could just create a commit directly. And I'll just commit directly since, you know, I'm just playing around. Usually I'd do a pull request so that people could comment on it and get visibility into what I'm doing. And so it's going to go ahead and set that up. It's going to commit that onto GitHub, and it's going to start my first build.
Okay.
And so now, and in fact, so while that's doing the build, it'll only take a second, but while that's doing the build, I can also go back and look at the build definition that was created. So I'll hit edit right here. Mm-hmm. And once that loads, I'll go to triggers. And so you can see what it's set up. It's set up a continuous integration trigger. So now anytime code is merged into the master branch, it'll kick off a build here. And anytime somebody opens a pull request, it will do this build validation. And so that's, you know, incredibly important as an open source maintainer. When somebody sends me a pull request, I want to know that it builds on all the platforms I support and that all my tests pass before I even, you know, really start looking seriously at the pull request. If it just fails all, you know, across the board, I don't have to spend much time. I can just suggest to them that maybe they need to do a little,
compile first. So I've noticed as well, so there's in GitHub in a lot of open source projects, when you submit a pull request, there's a series of checks that run.
That's right.
And the build is one of those. Does it actually compile and does it pass?
Right.
Is this integrating directly with that? Is that the same?
It's exactly the same, yeah. So you'll see the cute little pipeline spaceship in a pull request now as a check.
That's very cool.
Yeah.
Awesome. Nice. So, and if you want to change that build definition, the YAML's just sitting in your source repo, so you can change that however you need to.
Yeah, that's exactly right. The next time I fetch this repo, it'll pull that down, and I can just edit it in. I like VI, but you know, if you're an Emacs fan or VS Code.
Yeah. I'm VS Code all the way.
All right.
So this was the pipeline stuff for open source, and you can just do this for as many open source projects as you.
Yeah, absolutely.
Have. There's no charges, nothing like that. It's just continuously free for the moment.
That's
right?
Free. Yeah, it's free.
Nice.
Not for the moment. It's just free.
Just free. Just free. All right. Jet lag.
No, I hear you.
Nice. Oh, awesome. Thanks for showing us this. It's easy to get started. You mentioned it, like you walked through that whole process basically from scratch. Then, right?
That's right. And it just took, you know, a minute. So.
Yeah. And when that build completes, the other thing that I see in GitHub open source repos is like a build badge.
Yeah.
Is that?
Absolutely. So all I have to do is click this ellipses here.
Uh-huh.
In my builds and click status badge, and it'll actually give me the markdown. So it's the build hasn't doesn't have the build output yet, but as soon as it does, that'll turn green. So I can just copy that, and then I can flip back over to GitHub. And I can edit my README. Just click on the README and then click the pencil to edit it. For something like this, I'll just use the GitHub editor.
Yep.
Paste that right in. If I click preview, there we go. Now the build has
succeeded.
So it'll actually show me the green. And so now I can add the build badge and create a new pull request.
Okay. So we can test the...
That's exactly right.
Nice.
So click create pull request. And once that happens, this is what you're talking about. This is the checks area. It's yellow while it's analyzing what checks to need to run.
Mm-hmm.
And as soon as it realizes that Azure Pipelines is one of those checks, it kicks off that build.
Oh, very cool.
So it's yellow right now, meaning that it's in progress. I can click details, and that'll take me to the GitHub checks page. And then from there, I can go straight to Azure Pipelines. And I can even watch the build as it happens. So it'll provision an agent. It'll start downloading my NuGet tasks, and I just love to watch the build output. But you know,
I did the same thing.
What can I say?
Yeah.
And so as soon as this build actually completes and turns green, then the it'll report back to GitHub, and I'll be able to see that it'll turn green there too.
Right.
So and then that gives me a lot of visibility into. Yeah, the build process, and so I have comfort that this change is probably not doing too many bad things anyway. Obviously, I'm going to go code review it, but it gives me a nice sanity check.
That's some pretty deep integration.
Yeah, I love it, and it's like I said, it's super easy to set up. It just takes a couple minutes.
Yeah, definitely, and free, so no reason
it's
not
free.
To try it. Hey?
That's right.
Right. Awesome. Oh, thanks for walking me through that. That only took a few minutes.
Yeah,
that's good.
Absolutely. Yeah, my pleasure.
Awesome. Cheers. Well, thank you everyone for joining us, and we'll see you on another DevOps Lab pretty soon. Bye.